diagram shows a 1 kg pendulum being held stationary at rest by a 50 Newton horizontal force. Determine the magnitude and direction of the tension in the string of the pendulum. So you can represent the entire question by a free body diagram that shows the tension, the horizontal force, and the weight. Now, I'll try to explain why we get a closed vector triangle. Now, we know that using the triangle law, we know that when we move the forces, we shift the forces and arrange them properly, you will notice tip to tail, tip to tail, tip to tail. This shows that there is no resultant force, and this shows that there is a closed triangle, and the arrows are all pointing. If you can assume that they are all pointing in a direction. In this case, it looks like it's going a clockwise direction, or tip to tail. Now, if you look carefully, analyzing the forces, you realize that actually, in fact, the tension is actually counterbalanced by the resultant force of F and W and T, and the resultant force are in opposite direction, and we still obey Newton's first law. The object is at rest, resultant force zero. Now, if you look at the horizontal force, this horizontal force actually has the same magnitude as the resultant force of T and W. But F is in the opposite direction of resultant force T and W. And in line with Newton's first law, the sphere will be at rest because the resultant force, the overall resultant force, F, will balance T and W in that sense. If you analyze the weight is actually counterbalanced by the resultant force of, that's right, T and F. Since W is acting in opposite of the resultant force, it actually balances. Hence, because of this, all the three forces will form a closed triangle.